The task view. What is it and how do you get the most out of it? Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullin and in this week's episode, I'm taking you into the all new task view in Todoist Foundations. And most people have been wondering, what is it and how do I get the most out of it? And in this week's episode, that's exactly what I'm going to show you what you can do. Okay, now before I take you into Todoist, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this episode and you do like it, then please help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get regular updates and tips and tricks on Todoist, productivity and so much more, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into Todoist and I'll show you what the task view does. Right, now, before we go into the actual task view sheet, I suppose, if you want to call it, I just want to show you one thing. And the first thing is that you can actually add your labels in the traditional way. So I can actually do this, which, let's say I've got a thinking label there. I can actually add the date here. So I can type in today. And I can add in, I can actually even add the project using the hashtag in here as well. So if I wanted to put this into my foundations project, I can tap on that. However, there is another way of doing this. So I really want to point out that you haven't lost that ability, and that is really like quick processing. But the actual view that I want to show you is the task view, which gives you a little, I think it's nice because it actually helps to give you a little bit more time to think about what you actually want to do with the task. Now you can do, as I say, right here, you can see you can do the quick processing just using the keyboard shortcuts that we've always been able to do. But you can also take your time and show and think carefully about how you want to manage the task. And I actually like that because it makes you step back instead of rushing and just dumping stuff into projects or areas of focus. This is really helping you to make you think about what you really want to do with this task, which I think is always a good thing because these days a lot of people are not spending enough time thinking. Okay, another thing I wanted just to clear up from last week actually. Now to go into the task view, we'll start from here. To go into the task view and go into the inbox and you hit the I button right there. And that will give you basically everything you need with this task. So I've got what else is new in foundations, and we're currently in the inbox. Now if I tap that, it takes me straight back to the inbox. So that's not going to give you the project view. There's another way of doing that. Okay, we're going to tap on this one here, schedule. Now this will give you your date picker, and it's very good. You can tip the date if it's a long time in the future, let's say 20th of March, you know, I can do that and it's going to come up with 20th of March, you know, the next one. So I can do that, that's no problem. And of course I've got today, tomorrow, next week, blah, blah, blah. So that's all there. And that's just by tapping on the schedule. Now we come down here, we've got subtasks. So you can add subtasks directly to this particular task, not just the project, but the task. So you can just tap that. And I covered that a little bit last week anyway, so I'm not gonna go into too much detail, but you can just add the subtask like here. This is a subtask and that's in. So you can add that, and what if I come out of this for a moment, you can see that now that subtask has been added to the actual task itself. So that's something you want to be aware of. It doesn't just stay in the task view, it does show up on your list as well. Okay, so we've done that, and that also, by the way, if you look at that, that also has task view. So you've got quite a few of them there, so just keep that one in mind. You can go into each task will have its own task view. Okay, next coming up here is we've got the comments, and you can just add your comments in here. And by the way, just for those of you who are relatively new to Todoist, you do realize that you can actually, if you're going to tag that, you can actually drag documents from, add documents directly from your Dropbox or Google Drive folder. All you'd need to do is connect those, or of course, if this is on your computer, you can just drag and drop in files into this box here. That's something to keep in mind. So if you are a Dropbox user or Google Drive user, you can connect your accounts to Todoist and then have access to all your files in Dropbox or Google Drive or both. So there you go, that's something that I haven't mentioned for a while. Okay, coming up next, I'm going to go to this here. Now, this is the bit that I actually missed last week. Now, I'm just going to come out of here a minute. If I go into my what's new into Foundations project, you'll see that I've actually got a category called Step 2 of Project. That's in here. Now, there's no tasks in that right now. I do have this one here, which is the actual task that I created last week, but there's no task, but this is a category, and I want to show you something from here. Now, if you want to move this to a category, there is actually a way from the task view. You cannot do it from the, you cannot do it from this view. So if I do the project view, it's not going to give me the option. Even if I tap on there, it won't give me the option of moving it to a category, but there is a way of doing it, and I'll show you how to do that. So what we do is we go into this, and we go into the project, select a project. So I'm going to go to Foundation Project, and you'll see that what's happened is type a section, no section, or step to a project. It's right here. Now, I missed this simply because it's not actually very clear. I think the design team at Todoist will probably fix this in the near future. Either they'll blur the background, as you can see, very clearly underneath that, you can see areas of focus, business development. But I missed it completely because it's not very clear. Now, of course, I can type S-T-E-P and it comes up there, and I can just tap on that. And that now adds that project, as you can probably just see in the background, to my category. Now, the thing is, you do need to be aware of the categories that you have. You can add your labels from here, and you just tap on here. So let's just say this is a this is a subtask. So I'm going to say this is writing. You can just tap on there, and I can flag it. We can flag on here. I can add a priority one, and I can add an alarm to know whatever. That's actually a reminder. It's not just the date. Remember, the date is here. The schedule comes here. This is just actually adding a reminder. And then over here, I can now show completed tasks. I don't think there is any. I copy linked tasks, which I will cover in another episode what that actually does. Add comments via email, and it'll give you an email address for that. And you could just archive or delete the task. So you have a number of options, and this is really where you can manage the tasks that you are working from. But I really like the fact that you can actually do a lot within these systems. So review new task view, which is here. And I've got how to get back to the basic task. And as I said from last week, that when you tap a subtask, it disappears. All you have to do to bring it back is show completed tasks. And then I can just tap on there and it will bring them back right there. And you can see the task. Not too much, but what I really like about the task view is that you've got everything in one place. So you can see, you can organize a task, you can reschedule the task. You can still do that from the original way, but this is just a nicer, cleaner way. And it does make you think. And if you find that you are, for example, one of the things I see a lot of people having problems with is they have something like review new task view and say, oh, I'm not going to do that today. So they reschedule it for tomorrow and then reschedule it for tomorrow. What you could do is you can just open up the comments and just make a quick note. How many times are you rescheduling this? And that will give you a heads up and kind of like a warning that you're not doing this task, you're just rescheduling, which is, remember, not doing. Okay, hopefully that's given you a good overview of what the task view, the new task view feature is in Todoist Foundations. And to get to it, as I say, is just hit the information, the little I button there next to the task. It'll bring everything up and you can schedule it. You can do pretty much anything. You can even edit the task as well in here. Just tap on that and it will edit the task. So there you go. Hopefully you found this useful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below and I'll be more than happy to answer them. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now, have I got something special to tell you about? the Time and Life Mastery version 3 course has launched. Now, this course is transformative. It will transform your life. If you find that your life is drifting from one day to the next and that you feel that you're not actually achieving your goals, then this course is going to show you how to change that. It's going to show you how to identify what is truly important to you. It's going to show you how to find what it is you want out of life and then show you the steps that you need to take in order to get there. This course is amazing. The feedback I've got from versions 1 and version 2 have just been tremendous. It has helped so many people, and I want this opportunity to tell you that it can do the same for you. I hope you will take a look at the course, have a go, take the course, and start transforming your life today. This course will do that for you. Take a look, get yourself enrolled, and hopefully I'll see you in the course.